Welcome back, everybody. It is game number four now between Monkey Business and CIS Rejects, who finally got themselves a point on the board. It is now 2-1 to the favor of Monkey Business, but at least CIS Rejects have the momentum.
I honestly don't think that exists anymore.
Yeah, you don't think so?
Like, I was a big proponent on selling that 2 years ago when best of threes, I felt that drafting was so... I don't know, not important, like not as important as it is now. Mm-hmm. It was just more about play and having that momentum behind you with the play. I was like, right, well, you win the first game, lose the second game. I'm pretty sure the team that wins the second game is going to take the series. But now it's like there are so many little nuances and sort of pokes and jabs during the draft that the momentum just completely starts again. You know, you start from zero completely.
Yeah, I could see where you're going with that. I've heard a couple different pro players say that the draft is more important now than it used to be. And even just the last couple of patches meant so much more.
Like, I guess I shouldn't exaggerate and say momentum goes back to zero. Obviously, you still got, you know, adrenaline pumping and you do have some form of wind in your sails if you do win the previous game.
Yeah, but it means less than it used to.
Yeah.
All right, so... CIS Rejects, we took a very, very long time to figure out that they will, in fact, ban away the Leshrac, and now they're taking so much time with their second pick that they're losing a lot of their reserve. Monkey Business went straight up for the first pick, Lina, not terribly surprising. Very versatile hero and really valuable as a first pick. Earthshaker and Disruptor. For CIS Rejects, an early Disruptor pick is kind of weird, but Monkey Business...
Radiant team back.
Not really going to take too much time to address that one and instantly go for the Shadow Fiend on the Radiant side.
Yeah, Radiant SF, and this was first phase banned by CIS Rejects previously, right? They didn't want to let them have it. Mm-hmm. And with the Lina now switching
10 seconds remaining.
Could still be safe lane Lina, but more likely than not, it's going to be crit over on that again.
5 seconds
Tiny
remaining.
Tiny Wisp is still there. But I'm not sure if that's a great option against the Disruptor. You know, I think he's like 50-50 against the Tiny Wisp, something like that, whereas Winter Wyvern is a little bit stronger stats-wise against that combo. Wyvern is still in the pool, by the way, and I feel that that hero is not super underrated, but maybe should be shifting towards first phase pick.
5 seconds remaining.
Just because of how diverse he is. I guess he's... He's always a support hero, so he's not like Lina that can switch roles, but you can do a lot of things with Winter Wyvern.
Radiant team ban.
See, Queen of Pain going to be banned out by Monkey Business. Wisp taken out by CIS Rejects. Now the TA.
Dire team ban.
Some of the best laners versus SF and some of the best mids left in the pool there. In fact, there's... Most of the mids are gone. CIS Rejects, I guess, very likely to take Windranger, I would assume.
And Monkey Business have the Storm.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I guess you could ban out one or the other here.
Reserve time.
I'm not sure. Options are super limited. I was even bringing up Puck the other day just because of how many mid laners I see banned out in the draft nowadays. Mm-hmm. And we saw S4 run that... Wait, it was the game again that you were casting, right? Where they had Alliance, Puck,
dire
S4
team
Puck.
Pick.
Yeah.
Chen, Nature's Prophet.
Nature's Prophet.
Some other stuff which just didn't really
work
out.
Yeah, it was always just kind of like the TI3 draft.
I mean, I think Puck is still a hero. It's just that she's so low on the tier list compared to, you know, Templar Assassin who farms incredibly well. And it is down to that, really, you know, farming speed and efficiency. You want a mid laner who can flash farm at least
10
you know,
seconds
some stage
remaining.
In the game to either bridge the gap between herself and her opponent
Five
if she's behind from laning
remaining.
Phase, or create that gap to get ahead by, you know, 1,500, 2,000 net worth by sort
Reserve
of 12, 13
time.
Minutes. Which the Shadow Fiend definitely can do. You know, 12-minute mech is what... Usually you aim for.
Windranger at your service.
But we've seen a shift away from mech. TI5 was sort of the era of SF mech. You tank up, you go in brute force towers, and you have your team behind you.
Yeah.
From NA teams now, and I was talking to Clairvoyance with him when we were casting a game the other day, it's more about going sort of, you know, Sanjin Yasha, Shadowblade, BKB rush, going for a Hand of Midas if you have time, and going straight into like the physical damage, and then Helm of the Dominator Satanic later on.
Especially if your SF is your hardest carry. Mm-hmm. You really need to start going for those stats early.
Remaining.
Spirit Breaker.
Spirit Breaker now for Monkey Business in response to the Wind Ranger. CIS Rejects. We'll be able to put a lot of pressure on the SF in the early laning phase with the Wind Ranger and the Earthshaker. That's a lot of potential roaming, whether it's offlane or support, whatever. SF's going to be feeling that early laning phase pressure, which Spirit Breaker might be able to make up for. See whether or not he should be in offlane.
10 seconds
as
remaining.
As the Lina should already be taking that hard four position.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, highly likely. All three heroes can switch up, but the scenario you set up there is the more likely one, I feel. Earthshaker, though, he's got that Fisher against the Spirit Breaker, so if he gets vision of him, that charge isn't going to come through towards the middle lane. Mm-hmm. And Disruptor with a glimpse as well. It's going to be a hard Spirit Breaker game, honestly.
10 seconds remaining.
Maybe they... Maybe they do put him in support.
Radiant team.
Because there's three heroes already, Wind Ranger, Disruptor, Earthshaker, that really do stop that charge coming in. Do you rely fully on putting him in the offlane role? Because we've seen Monkey Business, they do need Moon Meander to get some farm. Like, he needs to kind of do well in his lane. He doesn't need to win it or crush it. But he cannot be shut down like he was in the previous game, Black Clockwork. Oh, they get themselves a Dazzle.
Dire team ban.
So it's looking more and more likely that it's going to be like you said. But great defensive support up against these guys. The Weave against Bristleback. The Quill Spray is really negated heavily by that bonus armor you get from it. And then you've got the negative armor to turn it back around
remaining.
From Shadow Fiend. Physical damage galore. Lina with the nukes. So far well-rounded.
5 seconds
They've got
remaining.
Initiation power. They've got sustain reaction. Plays here from Monkey Business are pretty high. You know, charge reaction, TP Grave. Lina
Radiant
can come in as well.
Team ban.
I don't know what they need to round out the draft, though. Because they've got pretty good synergy so far with Charge, Lightstrike Array, Requiem, and things like that. Miracle Hero-wise, I don't even know if Anti-Mage fits here.
10 seconds remaining.
Against the Bristleback, who can kind of just out-tank the damage, Wind Ranger with a Shackle and Static
Five
Storm Disruptor, they've got
remaining.
Ways of locking him down, and Monkey Business, I don't know if they can secure the farm time for... Okay,
Reserve
they ban
time.
Out the Huskar, yeah. That's a pretty sound ban. Even with the Wind Ranger out there with Focus Fire and the Quill Sprays, Huskar for Miracle could have been pretty ridiculous. So now it's either Goretz offlane Earthshaker or what? There's no more offlaners, apart from like the Centaur they had before. So yeah, they're looking at Goretz offlane Earthshaker.
Dire team pick.
Vanskor Hero to be fifth picked. Silencer? Not really going to work, because Vanskor usually picks that Disruptor. Oh, I guess it's the
yeah,
Orson
they've
of Fly
already
Hero.
Got the Disruptor.
Visage, I guess, is not too bad.
Kind of like it. The burst damage comes in. Good control.
Fast Medallion and Solar Crest.
Yeah, Fast Medallion for a Dire Side with Bristleback already in the pool. Plus, you already have the Wind Ranger Focus Fire as well.
5 seconds remaining.
Roshan could be very easy for CIS Rejects to take.
Radiant team.
Do you think
pick.
It's going to be a Miracle SF or... Okay, Wraith King. Where on earth is this going to go? So is that offlane Bristleback then? And Earthshaker Disruptor supports Wind Ranger mid, Wraith King safe lane? Okay. Well, we'll see how they actually set things up here. But Monkey Business, I think Miracle, Shadow Fiend mid. An Ember Spirit pick here from No Tail is probably what they would have fallen back on if it wasn't a Wraith King final pick. Just because
5 seconds
they can get the damage out. But Phantom Lancer... Okay. No Tail Shadow Fiend. No Tail Phantom Lancer, yeah. I was so sold on the Miracle Shadow Fiend until that Phantom Lancer pick, and then it's kind of up in the air.
Yeah.
But that's what they go for. So Moon will be the offlane Spirit Breaker. We'll see how he does. It's going to be rough.
I always side with the Phantom Lancer. Pretty much always.
Well, Diffusal Blade against Bristle and Wraith King.
Yeah, I mean, both of these strength carries are just get destroyed once their mana is completely gone. Wind Ranger I mean, she's got the... what. The one thing they do have for them is lots of initiation. Right? Earthshaker, Windranger may pick up a Blink Dagger. You also have the potential
Prepare
for Wraith King
for
to go for the Blink Dagger build, which we saw from last game. Blink Dagger, Blade Mail, etc., etc. So there's a lot of potential here for... I was trying to fix this earlier, but our overlays were slightly messed up for some reason. There we go. That's all better. It's all better now. Now you can see the KDA. Alright, so what's the plan here for the landing phase, though? Monkey Business are going to start out with an aggro try. Against Wraith King, Disruptor, Earthshaker. This would keep a lot of pressure off of the SF when they run the aggro time. I kind of like this idea just because I think they can win it.
They did this the other day. It felt super, super weird. But yeah, when you put it that way, it does draw a lot of attention away from Miracle. And I'm pretty sure it was against an Earthshaker as well. I can't remember what the other components were, but... I know Monkey Business had like Ember Dazzle plus one against an Earthshaker plus whatever it was.
Block out, but they do have the rest of the team coming in from the side, and this means it's actually going to play against them as Iceberg immediately gets stunned up. Artez goes back. He knows he's kind of done for here. Crit is going to land the Light Strike Array, and he will be right click down for the first blood. No, the misraise. Somebody get it. Oh, God. They're not going to get it. 25 HP. Wraith King gets out. He's. Oh, wow.
I mean, Salve is popped, but who got Bounty Runes there? Bristol and Lina. It's honestly not that bad. Like, First Blood is less meaningful than it used to be. The gold and XP spread you actually get across the board isn't that massive. Killing the Wraith King, like, he's got a TP back to base. He has no regen.
Yeah.
He's already being crushed pretty massively here. The big thing is, though, I thought Miracle might go for Necromancy first to try and get the last hit, because you get yourself a ton of souls to start things off. 12 souls as soon as you kill a hero, and that wins you the lane almost against the Windranger. But going for the raid and missing it?
Yeah, that last raid really cost him quite a bit. He could have a bottle already. Top lane, they will get first blood. Wraith King comes back and immediately gets dumped on. So he's dead now. Still, I want to watch this matchup just because I want to see how the SF is going to do against this Windranger after the kind of wonky start. Because he's doing really well for himself so far. With the raise first, he's gotten 7-1. He's out of mana now, but he just needs one more CS and he'll have the bottle. But he gets caught here. Fisher block. Oh, not quite enough. Iceberg. He doesn't have enough damage out from the power shot to finish him off. So.
Nice bottle.
Yeah, the bottle will come in now as well as that shared tango.
Is it going to be fast enough to get second minute rune, though?
I don't think so.
Well, no one's defending top rune. Miracle is low, but Iceberg.
Light Strike Array lands on Advanced Core. The stun turned around onto Crit, but they're going to go for this kill on Crit. They probably will be able to get it. No, they're not.
LSA ready again, but not turning. Okay.
Yeah. So they get out. First blood. Moon, meanwhile, is battling out with Goretz here in this bottom lane. He's a level 2 Spirit Breaker. Level 3 Bristleback. Getting some decent 17% so far from what I've seen.
Every coin helps.
Man, Miracle's crushing this. Under the tower, misses only one last hit from a 1.5 wave. Jory's got raises to help himself out, but still.
Oh, this is actually really important. The courier was at the bottom lane. He took the bottle, and this means it's going to stall up the Windranger quite significantly. But Goretz can make up for that if he gets a kill on Miracle somehow with this haste rune.
Is this going to happen?
Hello, top lane. Fly in some trouble here. Does have the Shell Grave, so he should be okay.
Oh, Miracle's dead.
Yeah, he runs right into Goretz. Goretz immediately starts going in. We'll be able to get this kill. There's no save. It's just a bit too late, and there's certainly no turnaround kill on Goretz, so. This will actually, Goretz will still be ahead of Moon in experience because he got that kill. So there's not even anything gained in the bottom lane for this.
Spirit Breaker versus Bristleback lane. Bristleback should win this pretty handily, right? Like, unless you get godlike bashes out from the RNG.
Yeah, I'm not quite so sure, because Spiritbreaker has really naturally high armor, and he goes for the early magic wand, so there's not much damage being dealt by the Quill Spray because of the armor.
I mean,
yeah, there's no way you win. There's no way you get a kill. But
17%, yeah. I mean, that was,
I
that
think
was
it's not bad for the Spiritbreaker.
Right? Two bashes. Yeah. But, I mean, the the Bristleback should be able to out-farm.
Oh, yeah. I agree. Out-farm, I don't think he'll be able to push the Spiritbreaker entirely out of lane, but still. Top lane. Lance goes out. Artez kind of trapped in the trees here. Doppelganger, they're just going full. What a shadow wave.
Crap.
Nice control there from Big Daddy No-Tail surrounding that Wraith King and Illusions. And Fly does comply with a nice shadow wave.
Level 2 Shadow Wave.
Insane.
How much HP does Wraith King have? 700? 720?
Something like 660.
Oh, he's not even that. Okay.
Yeah, he doesn't have any stat items. He's died three different times, too. Miracle? Is this a kill for Iceberg? Pops a regen. Shackle Shot latches. Miracle allows it. He just runs right in there. Next set of trees does end up going down. Moon bumping back Goretz once again.
Oh, that's a great thing, actually. The fact that he's against the Bristleback means that he's getting the stick charges, which allows him to spam charge.
Yeah, he routinely is just charging into him every single time because he's got so much extra magic to use, so much extra mana. They're going for Artez again. Fly. Get away. Nah. They've kind of overextended themselves a little bit, so they're stuck back.
But they've got no turn power here. Like, in Fisher to block them off, Glimpse to try and defend the racing, but how much CS does he have? 7-1?
Oh, Moon! What? Whoa, Moon! He dove in, he picked up his level 6, and he gets the kill on the Bristleback. That is huge. But yeah, you're right, 7-1 on the Wraith King. I was looking at the CS and going, oh, wow. I mean, like we talked about, the Dazzle Phantom Lancer combination is really strong, but I've never seen it used so offensively before. Always want to Fly, goes for the block off, hits two there, and Fly is forced to just turn around. Oh my god, what a shackle! Shackle through the trees! Fly's now going to be able to turn around. The Artez comes forward, gets the stun, but with the jump forward now, all they need is really good Shadow Wave or another raise. No, always want to Fly, does barely manage to survive. Artez not as lucky. And a rack up another kill. 4 deaths now for the Wraith King. He's going to have more deaths than CS by this point.
Don't look at it that way. No.
Poor Artez. I mean,
Vanskor has 7 CS.
Charge in. Goretz is not the target, though. He's the only one full HP. Everyone else from CISR drops super low in that fight. But
Dire's middle tower
Moon, coming to challenge.
Attack.
Pop a W. Pop it. No. Bounty. Picked up by Goretz. And yeah, I mean, look how many. He laid out 3 quills, and he just doesn't seem to put a dent in the Spiritbreaker. High armor and high HP.
Yeah, now he's got double gauntlet and treads. There's just no way. And yeah. This right here, what Goretz is doing, is what he has to do. Because he knows he's died once, got 1 kill, 24 CS is good and all. But he needs items to function, right? The Bristleback can't just go in and do stuff. He needs treads, Vanguard, Sand and Yasha, AC. He has a progression he needs to follow. And he cannot be stopped in that progression, or else he becomes a non-factor in team fights. He just becomes, you know, a meat shield walking around not doing too much. Whereas the Spiritbreaker has charge and Nether Strike. His job is to initiate. He doesn't care about items too much. Shackle, mid, Miracle's caught. But the reaction's coming in.
Oh, they will have a Shallow Grave, so a quick retreat comes out. They know diving into Miracle would be a very bad idea. Meanwhile, the top tower does get taken out. Big Daddy, he's low in levels right now because they're running an aggro tri-lane, but he's got a high amount of net worth. 202, he's 39-20. He's second in net worth board right behind the SF. The fact that you're keeping up with the SF at this point in the game is good enough, essentially.
SF doesn't have stacks though, does he, right?
No.
He's been clearing out medium camp every time he can when he's pushed the wave out, which is, you know, Shadow Fiend, Radiant Side, that's just what happens, but no one has been able to because of this aggressive tri-lane stack camp for him. Bot lane, Moon's charging forward!
Yeah, I mean, he just doesn't really care too much about this dual lane.
Does he just keep on going? If he gets another strike onto Vanskor, he could kill him!
He really could. has another charge up and still has enough mana for the combination. He'll have an earn soon as well. It's a lot of incentive for him to pick up a kill.
Have we seen what Shadow Beaten's building? He's just gone for the regular opener. Treads Aquila Wand. I mean, the wand sometimes people skip, but against Windranger who's spamming out Shackle Shots and Power Shots. Like that? Honestly. The wand comes in so useful. And then in mid-game team fights, Bristle Back obviously.
Why is he the extra damage needed? Gonna be, oh, 17% starting things off right. Moon trying to get off the ultimate ahead of the stun. Can't quite get it. Still though, putting pressure on the Wraith King. The turnaround though, Goretz is here, so Monkey Business will be forced back. Their dual lane is still potentially stronger than this tri-lane.
Bristleback even tried to buy a Ring of Health from the secret shop. And then he sold it. Yeah. Oh. But he's got 1500. I kind of want him to just buy treads now. Tread switching is so important on a hero like Bristleback, especially when you've got wand and bottle. Oh, God.
He gets off the stun, but he's still going to be right click down. Right click one more time. You can do it. I believe in you. Yeah, you got it.
Moon. He's fine. He could even charge back onto Earthshaker or Iceberg here, actually. He's just going to TP back.
TP's back. Fly. They catch him. Oh, they definitely got it. Fly is done for. Glimps back right to the waiting arms of Iceberg. Shot through the heart.
But who's to blame?
I think that would be the Ringwraith.
Okay.
Invisibility!
I'm glad you picked that up so quickly. That makes me smile. Crit. He's got Lacuna Blade. This really is not that easy. A fight, especially charge coming through.
Oh, the bash
hit
again!
Artez. Bashed up.
And again.
Bash one more time.
And again.
You know what? Just call him Bash Lord.
What the hell?
Middle lane? Miracle. Yeah, three heroes around him, but that the Windranger, it's a bit too low, and now the charge is going to come in through the side. Oh, but it's not on the Windranger. It's on Always Want to Fly instead. What is he doing? Good God, man. He just doesn't stop. He pops the urn onto Iceberg. Crits runs forward. Laguna Blade? Can't get it. Shackle shot. Now Crits dead. Chain stunned up. Moon, you're sticking around too long, my friend. That was way too aggressive by both of you.
Dire structures are fortified.
Artez has not hit level 6 yet, and he is running in.
Moon charge away. No, he charges in. Always Want to Fly pops that ultimate. Now Always Want to Fly is going to be left for dead. It's Miracle. Long range race doesn't have it. 5 seconds on cooldown. Moon will actually be able to survive. Heals across the board. Looks like everyone is good for now, but they want to get it. Artez will be able to get the stun. Fly, another heal out. Has the Shallow Grave still.
76 charges.
Tackle shot. Shallow Grave gets laid out now. Moon comes in from the side. Will be able to stun up with a charge. Iceberg. Power shot misses. He's going to die now as the lance comes in through the side. They've taken out the Earthshaker.
Charge is
They've
ready.
Got the Windranger. And now Goretz is going to die as well. The charge slowed down by the lance. Bumped by the Spirit Breaker. And Big Daddy No Tails on a mega kill streak already. 10-4.
Everyone on the Radiant has a magic wand or a magic stick. And it honestly is making the difference here. Everyone, so I swear I keep looking at people. They've got 17 stick charges, 17 wand charges, whatever. And this is why CRS Rejects just cannot find a break. They're looking for kills. They're looking for that execution moment where they're like, right, we've got them. 17 stick charges, back to half HP. What are you going to do? Graved up, what are you going to do?
They're just not finding the openings. It's 12 minutes in, so much action, and I haven't taken a look at the network chart just yet, but 6K on both the PL and the SF. Next up is 4,500 on the Windranger. And then immediately behind him by 10 gold is the Spirit Breaker, who's at the same marker.
Do you know how long the Wraith King walked around in that middle fight waiting for level 6? There was one Radiant creep actually running around in circles. Artez couldn't kill it because it was like 3/4 HP.
Uh-huh.
And in the end, he got level 6, didn't have mana for his ultimate. So he's like, screw it, I'm going to throw a stun then and run away. But he is super underleveled. Like, the same level as Disruptor and Earthshaker level.
Yeah. Speaking of underleveled, Goretz is going to remain a little underleveled and underfarmed because his stack mechanic has been taken away. Sentry Ward blocking that one out for a couple more minutes. Now the SF has his mech, so teamfight potential over the roof now for Monkey Business. Between the Spirit Breaker, so damn big. What's he got? He's got something coming to him.
Radiant's bottom tower
is under
attack. Oh,
he's gonna go for
the
Shadowblade, not terribly surprising. And Moon, he'll find Vanskor here. Hello, charge up. Fisher will interrupt him. Vanskor does have his ultimate. He'll be able to get it off, stopping Moon from being able to pop his own ultimate. Okay. Now the Lash comes in from the side, but Big Daddy O'Tail, he's just gonna go from one to another. Earthshaker, next up Vanskor. He just surrounds him real quick, gets that kill. They're going to turn onto Iceberg. The charge is coming right through.
Oh,
they're going to be able to catch him. And Moon still has his ultimate, so the Windrun's going to fade. And now they look for Artez, who does not have a TP scroll. And I believe Monkey Business know this.
He's got his ulti, but he's got 56 charges. Not
even
going to
bother
with
it. Not even worth it. You just die two times in a row. Now they charge into middle lane. Don't tell me. Don't tell me it's going to be a wipe. Earthshaker's alive, Sangles with the Disruptor, but can they actually save Goretz from the 17% monster right in the face? Raise one, raise two,
I got another
17% to finish him off! Moon, I don't know how you do it! Good lord, buy a lottery ticket, go gamble, what is happening? One hit, 17%. Two hits, three hits, only one.
Dire's middle tower.
And then on top of all of this, look what Crit just picked up. 14 minutes support Yules on this Lina. I mean, a 12-minute Yule Scepter on a mid Lina is good. I guess, you know, there's Ted's boss and stuff to come beforehand, but ridiculous amount of farm. Wait, whoa, hello?
Yeah, Moon just casually comes through the side. Whatever. I'm a cow. No big deal. He's actually trying to survive with his Invis, but that's not going to happen. Now Flies is an overextender now. And he should die, Miracle. Not even gonna try. Big Daddy No Tail though comes. Jackal, not latching. Glimpse also not really doing much there. Miracle threatening the ultimate on the side, waiting for his opportunity. Artez, gotta be careful here. He doesn't have a whole lot of mana, still a lot of charges. Miracle, when are you gonna let that one go? He's just making noise, finally goes out, hits on three. Artez is down, but he's trapped. Oh, maybe it's Miracle is the one who's trapped inside with the Disruptor ultimate. Crit sitting on the side trying to get out some damage, but this is just a bad fight, it looks like. But with the SF dying, everyone's low, and Big Daddy No-Tail, he'll be able to get one. A second one, Iceberg, no, he just barely lives. And it looks like Big Daddy No-Tail, he needs to back out here. Light Strike Array, Artez, Doppelganger, oh my god, the Power Shot missed! Oh, they're all so low. Big Daddy No-Tail, don't do it, man.
Moon, go in. Moon, go in.
He's going ham. Ultimate, earn, and a lance. Big Daddy No-Tail finds yet another one. The tier two is going to fall as well. It's 20-7, and this game.
There's one
I mean,
big.
This is something I expect out of CISR, but Monkey Business are being full-out aggression right now, and they're winning. And winning and winning and winning.
I think there's one reason for this. There's this big glaring hole in the draft that we haven't really touched on. We talked about how great Phantom Lancer is against the Wraithling and the Bristleback. What do CIS Rejects have that's good against the Phantom Lancer? Earthshaker with a blink.
Yeah.
And that seems like pretty much it. So I really feel like the Rejects have to get this blink over onto Always Wanna Fly. But how do you do this? Because Big Daddy has... He's not died once, and I don't foresee him dying in the future unless he just, you know, goes in and kills himself pretty much.
Yeah, exactly. The only reason he came close to dying earlier is just it was simple super, super aggro. But you're completely right. I mean, the only way to deal with the Phantom Lancer was they had to win their lanes early. They had to get, like, Blink Daggers, Initiating Tools, and just keep the Phantom Lancer down because once he gets to the point that he's at now, he's damn near impossible to stop.
Beautiful play, DOTs. It's 17 minutes in. They know this Roshan's happening, right?
Oh,
they're just waiting for the
God.
PL. They're just going to walk in here, waltz in, and rip
and
them apart.
As soon as they're revealed, Moon, oh, TP out. Everybody run. CIS Rejects. The charge comes in. No one's escaping. Vanskor is going to be caught and almost dies instantly to the combination of the Spirit Breaker thanks to that Shadow Blade. They're looking for more.
You
have it. Crit is going to be able to find Always Want to Fly. No Blink Dagger for you, at least not for another 10 minutes at least. And Goretz, be away, charge, oh my god, he got hit. He got stunned, but still completed the TP.
15,000 network, 18 minutes in. This is very much business, and I even got the Roshan to seal things up as well.
All right, well done by our Lurker Derp stats woman.
Stats person.
Did you notice that stat title?
Bash God. I didn't read the full title.
Beginning to feel like a Bash God. Is under attack. The starting lyrics of Bash God.
Oh, yeah. The memes.
22 to 7, 18 minutes in, a 15,000 gold lead, 12,000 experience, monkey business. I mean, it's all but over at this point in time, and they haven't even broken a base, but that's just how far ahead they are with this kind of draft. It's going to be caught here. All right, here's the start. They're going to be able to chain stun him pretty quickly and take him down, but they'll lose a lot of damage on their tier 3.
DD Shadow Fiend with Aegis Yasha.
Yeah, he's dealing 300 damage a hit. Oh, oh no, the control from No Tail is just not quite there. Miracle. Doesn't care. He has an Aegis. He has a mech. Fight me if you dare. Yule Scepter. Oh, Wind no, Ranger? The ultimate iceberg. Oh, wait, Miracle. He stopped it. He's like, no, I don't need it. I'll just right-click him down. It's all Gucci. Big Daddy No Tail glimpse back. Oh, three-man Fisher, but it's still not enough. Monkey Business are just rampaging through all of this. Gorat's trying to challenge Miracle, who's at half HP, but no, thank you. You got to back up.
She walked into that. Oh, Iceberg walked into that.
Yeah. I have no idea what that was, but now he's going to be...
Oh, you dead again.
Defusaled. Not quite
dead. Another Lance. But they have no Echo.
No Tail, Lance, Spirit. Oh, they don't get the shot. Wait, no, no, they got the shot.
No, they didn't. It was Rift by Blast.
Right? Oh, okay. Big Daddy No Tail still turning around. The charge right through. Bumps back four. Vanchcore's already dead. Goretz is going to fall in a second here. There goes our reincarnation as well. Miracle, he's got an Aegis. He don't care at all. Artez is rapidly going to be burned out of all of his bid. He backed in. Big Daddy No Tail, he's being controlled right now, but the Shallowgrave's still there. Iceberg's dead
they're
as
all,
well.
They're all dead.
It's everything. 27 to 8. They got one kill in exchange for like seven. And Goretz is coming back to look around to be the eighth. And GG is going to be called before that can happen. Always want to fly. Says it's over. And our series is done for. 3-1. Monkey Business. It started out so close with that game number one. A 67-minute game with Miracle controlling everything with his Animage. Game two taken by a Big Daddy No Tail and Crit Wisp Tiny combination. Game number three was where CISR were able to strike back, but still, Monkey Business came back even harder in game four, harder than game two.
Yeah, and we were talking about it before the draft, momentum and importance of the draft itself. I feel here that CIS Rejects, you know, they had a plan, they knew what they wanted to do, but the Phantom Lancer aggressive tri-lane just completely stopped them. They got Bristleback versus the Spirit Breaker, which, you know, was relatively even, but Moon Meander was, he was enabling fights a lot faster than the Bristleback could. Bristle could go and gank mid lane with a lucky haste rune, you know, maybe find a regen rune to come back to lane and farm, or get into the ancient stacks that he made up for himself, but Moon Meander was just charging, 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 never, ever giving up. What did No Tail end on? 908. That's the story right there.
Yep. So much space created by Moon, and Big Daddy No Tail took every ounce of space and pushed it to the limit. And that means we now have our team, Monkey Business, off of this 3-1 victory, are going to be going to New Orleans. Congratulations to them. We still have more MLG. We've got the American qualifiers that are being run through right now, so there's going to be a lot more here on this channel. But be sure to just always check out joindota.com, where we have... tons of casting. Tomorrow's a small day where there's only one series of casting really going on. But after that, we have like 3-4 games going on at a time. Sometimes it's crazy. So just go to joindota.com. Whenever you have some free time, you want to watch some Dota, we'll have something going on. I can all but guarantee it. But thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you guys next time for the American qualifiers.